Daven, the first time I met you, we were sharing a stage at a local presentation about entrepreneurship and small business ownership. That's where I learned about who Daven Michaels is. You have surrounded yourself with experts and you've brought them to the table in a website under your own name, Daven Michaels. Tell us about the evolution of this website, Daven Michaels.
Yeah, sure, John. Well, you know, I think a lot of entrepreneurs or most entrepreneurs are always doing 47 different things. And I'm not an advocate of that at all. As a matter of fact, for the last decade, I've been building one company. It's called 123 Employee. It's an outsourcing company, as you know. And today we have over 550 employees on three continents. And people often ask me, Daven, you know, what is your secret to success? And unfortunately, I don't have one. I just focused on one business for about a decade. And something kind of funny happens. If you focus on one thing for a long, long time, eventually you'll figure it out and you get it right. And so I've been doing that. But no matter what, even if you're focusing on one business, there's still some tentacles. You know, I'm a speaker. I speak on stages all over the globe. I'm an author. I write books. My 10th book is actually hitting the bookstores this weekend. I'm actually on a book tour. So there's other things I do. You know, I do interviews. There's all kinds of things I do. And people are interested in what I do. I'm kind of a thought leader, and that's a part of my marketing. And so as a result, I feel it's important that I have a branding site. And so I think most entrepreneurs should have a branding site. It's a great way to market yourself. And so that's my site, davenmichaels.com. And it's a place where you can go and kind of find out what I'm up to. It links to all of my businesses and it links to articles and videos and interviews and everything about me. And so it's a good place to kind of check in and see what I'm up to and get more information on the things that I'm promoting and doing.
In your evolution of developing what has become your branded site, how did you discover that you needed to surround yourself with mentors and people that are going to help you get to the level that you're at now? Because nobody can build it all on their own. How'd you get there?
You know, I've been a mentor for the last decade, and I've been mentoring thousands of people all over the globe. That's a part of what I do. And it's funny, I have so many friends who've been mentors to me over the years. And of course, I've been fortunate to just have some wonderful mentors over the years. The interesting thing is that I've actually never had like an actual coach until a couple of years ago, actually. And then I actually got one. And boy, that was a real game changer for me. And I can't believe that, you know, I've been self-employed for over three decades and never actually had a coach. All my friends did, but I do now. And he's wonderful. And he's an absolute genius. But even if he wasn't, you know, it, just having somebody that is not in your business is probably one of the most valuable things that you can possibly have, because the problem with you and your business is that nobody knows your business better than you do. You are the preeminent expert in your business. You created it, you live it, you eat it, you sleep it. It's your business. But the problem is that you're so deeply ingrained in your business that you can't see outside your business. And there's so many things as a business owner that are in your blind spot, because you just see it day in, day out. And when you work with somebody or you have somebody that sees your business with new eyes, it's totally invaluable. And so mentorship, of course, is fantastic. There are always people that have walked, no matter what you've done in your life or no matter what you want to achieve, there's always somebody that has walked before you. And if you can latch on to them, of course, they'll shortcut your way to success. But also just having somebody that can look at your business, that can review and evaluate your business, that's not in your business, they're going to pick up things that you just can't see because you're too deep in your business. And that is just hugely valuable.
Oftentimes, we as entrepreneurs, it's like we're speaking in a foreign language to others. We know so much about what we're doing, but when we try to convey that message, they give us that deer in the headlight look, and I get it in my own household. It's, what are you talking about? And it seems so simple to me, but breaking it down as you just described and as you talk about when you get on stage is so important so that you can explain it in such a way that anyone can understand it.
Yeah. You know, it's interesting that you said that, John, because I started my business at 15 years old. I was just a kid when I started my business. And I had nothing when I started my business. I had no education. I had no money. I had no resources. I had no connections. I had no community. We didn't even have social media back then. I mean, I literally had nothing. And it was so hard for me. I mean, it was the hardest thing I ever did in my life, starting my business. It was brutal. And I wouldn't wish that on anybody. And recently, as you know, I started something new, and it wasn't driven by wanting to, it wasn't monetarily driven. It wasn't, you know, wanting to make a profit. It was just purely a passion project, which to a certain degree was stupid, because the last thing you want to do when you have a successful company is start something new. But I did it last year. my goal was to create the number one association for entrepreneurs all over the globe, because I wanted to have a place where everybody could speak the same language and relate to each other and give each other a leg up. And I actually started something new. It's called VIA, the Virtual Entrepreneurs Association. And it's all the tools, resources, discounts, education, community that the entrepreneur needs and wants, but not just the entrepreneur, but one that really kind of wants to have a business and a life that they design rather than a life that their business dictates for them. Somebody that wants to kind of have a virtual lifestyle, wants to travel the globe, live life, you know, on their own terms, but still, you know, have a thriving business. For example, like me, I'm kind of an anomaly. I have a brick and mortar business. I have hundreds and hundreds of employees. We have three centers. We have people all over the globe. But even then, I'm still able to run my business from a cell phone and laptop. And I do it from some of the most exotic places on the planet. And I love that. It's the funnest thing ever. And I wanted to show people how to do that all over the globe and build a massive association. And think of it as kind of the AAA for business, if you will. And we launched it last year, and we literally had thousands of people join in the first few days. And it was so cool. And it's just been fun. It's just been so cool to be able to, you know, help entrepreneurs give them a leg up so they didn't have to go through what I had to go through when I was trying to start my business.
Well, and to take advantage of the opportunities, my audience here can go to bizsoup.com and you can go to the latest episodes, check out Daven Michaels, Business Soup, where business comes for business. And we're talking with Daven Michaels about his website under his own name, Daven Michaels. You've got multiple entities, as you just mentioned, and you're able to utilize technology to empower yourself to work from anywhere. When you started out at the age of 15, we didn't have those tools.
No.
You couldn't do that. And I remember being the master of a fax machine and a pager at that time. And I thought I was king of the real estate world with that technology. You've got some things that are called Beyond Results Mastery. You've got the Mastery Retreats. And tell us about the Beyond Results Mastery.
Yeah, sure. So let me kind of back up a second. So when I started my outsourcing company, 123 Employee, over a decade ago, our sweet spot was we were doing outsourcing for small businesses, primarily sort of virtual assistant services. And we do all the busy stuff, or BS, busy stuff for entrepreneurs. So things like internet marketing, social media, telemarketing, back office tasks, inbound, outbound voice, customer service. Basically, all the busy stuff in their business so they can focus on the income generating activities in their business and the things that really juice them and excite them. Our mission at 123 Employee is to rescue lifestyle starved entrepreneurs, give them their time back and their lives back. We love doing it. Now, when we started the company well over a decade ago, entrepreneurs needed this service, but they certainly didn't want it per se because they didn't know it existed. And we realized very early on that if we wanted to have a market for this, we would have to somehow carve out this market, if you will, because it really didn't exist. So we had to figure out how to do it. So we decided to adopt an educational model. And I started writing books, eventually became a New York Times bestseller. So a lot of books got out there. I started creating info products. I started speaking on stages all over the globe. And we started doing events all over the planet. And we began educating our prospects and eventually turning them into clients. And that's still a model that we use to this day. And first of all, it works, but also we just love doing it. It's just super fun. And one of the components of that is our events. And so we had delivered these events in Australia, the US, Europe, Asia, New Zealand. And some of these events we do Process to Profit Live, we do Beyond Business Live, we do Outsource Live, we do Beyond Marketing Live. And then we also have our mastermind. So kind of the more elite entrepreneurs, or the entrepreneurs that are moving towards elite status, are really proactive and really growing their business to, and they want to take it to the next level. They join my masterminds. And these are very small elite groups of people that meet with me about four times a year. And we meet at one of my homes, usually in Vegas, and then, or in Puerto Rico, which is where I live full time.
We're talking with Daven Michaels of DavenMichaels.com. Check out BizSoup for more information and offers that Daven's going to make for us, for our listeners here at BizSoup.com. And there's so much more that we can talk about on Business Soup here, but Daven, we've got to cut this one short and invite you to come back again and continue this conversation about some of your books on virtual assistants. So, Daven, I want to thank you for being a part of this serving of Business Soup, coast to coast. Daven Michaels, thank you.
Thank you.